So I can see here the faces are energyless. I would like to say one thing to you. You are sitting here since morning, and I am 100% sure that definitely we're going to be a great leader manager. So please clap for yourself and for the dignitaries and faculty members here. Fantastic, great. So ladies and gentlemen, a very exciting good afternoon to one and all present here. So today, myself, Divesh Sharma, and my partner,
Rajat Ayalwar,
standing before you with a case study on Flipkart, from a startup to a brand. Can we have the next slide, please? Yes, ma'am. Actually, we have chosen Flipkart as our topic because Flipkart has never disappointed me. I am following Flipkart since 4 or 5 years. And I am very inspired by his motivational stories of the founders, Binny Bansal and Sachin Bansal. So that is the main reason I have chosen this topic. So next slide, please. So here we're going to move this presentation through this fashion. We will start with introduction, founders, history, and middle of the presentation there will be some stats, and end of the this presentation there would be short challenge for Flipkart and then conclusion. Next slide. Okay, so we have here introduction. You can see here it's an e-commerce industry online marketing platform founded in October 2007, and the founders are Sachin Bansal and Binny Bansal, as we all know. After that, currently the owner of Flipkart is Walmart. We know in 2018 it acquired Flipkart with 77% stake. And the CEO, Mr. Kalyan Krishnamurthy, headquarters we know it's based on Bangalore, India. And revenue as per the data of March 31st, 2018 is 30,164 crores. And according to 2016 data, number of employees working in 2016 with Flipkart is 30,000. Can we have the next slide?
Yeah, now the founders, Sachin Bansal and Binny Bansal. They graduated from the IIT Delhi and they started a business in a 2 BHK in Bangalore with a very low investment for the website design, 4 lakh only. And after getting rejected in Google 2 times, they started their own company, like the Flipkart. Bansal always says that focus on one category. They started their business with a book selling. They succeeded in after that they introduced another one. And second one is the low cancellation rate. Many of the e-commerce companies they charges 30% and more than 30%, but they were charging only 2% cancellation rate. Speed of delivery. They try to reach their customer within 2 or 3 days, and simple web interference.
Yeah. All right. So we have here history and initial capital. Yeah, my friend rightly said that they started the company Flipkart with 4 lakhs initial investment. They were living in a 2 BHK flat, and Sachin Bansal and Binny Bansal, both of them were delivery boys. This is how they just started. So you can just imagine what a motivation they were having. And started with online bookstore in 2010 to 2018. You can see how they flowed. Acquired VRead, acquired mime360.com in 2011. 2012 introduced online music store, DRM Free Flight. That is a music store, but it did not work out because of free streaming websites, music websites on internet. And after that, 2014, we were having the Big Billion Days. You can see, you might be knowing that 1 rupee pen drive, they were available in Big Billion deal. And in 2017, purchased Indian subsidiary eBay. Again in 2017, Big Billion Day. And 2018, Walmart acquired Flipkart with 77% stake. Next slide.
So why Flipkart? It is 24/7 customer service, cash on delivery, and 30 days replacement policy, EMI option, and newly introduced prepaid policy.
Next slide.
Yes.
Yes, here I have shown merger and acquisitions. Here we will describe the how Walmart acquired Flipkart. 70% stake in Flipkart for about 1,04,000 crore. And second one is May 2014, Flipkart acquired Myntra, an online fashion retailer, for rupees 2,000 crores. And the third one in 2016, Flipkart acquired Jobong.com from Rocket Internet for 476 crores. Next slide.
So achievements of the Flipkarts. In 2013, Bansal's got awarded Entrepreneur of the Year by Economic Times. In 2015, Bansal's named as the 86th richest person in India by the Forbes India. And in 2016, the Time magazine included the Bansal's in the topmost 100 influential people in the world list. In 2017, India Today included Bansal's and his co-founder, India's 15 most powerful people in India.
Absolutely, even we have long list of achievements. These are very few. Okay, so competitors analysis. Yeah, Rajat, continue. Yeah.
The competitor analysis. So we can see our market share in India is 44%. It's greater than Amazon. But our revenue in 2018 is 30,164 crore and Amazon is 15,14,500.
Absolutely. So here, growth of the Flipkart. Initial days in 2016 to 2017, it was working finely. Means 15,403 was the revenue. Loss was 5223. In 17, it was good. But in 2018, you can see the revenue is less. Loss is greater than revenue. So that is the striking effect in 2018. So still now, investors believe in Flipkart because they think that they have a future. So that is why they are still investing. Next slide. Yeah, so most preferred online apparel, if you see this data based on May 2019, here you can see 80.57% of the people preferring Amazon. Just below that we have Flipkart. So still we have hope. Definitely it's Flipkart gonna rock. Next slide.
So Flipkart key statistics. Registered users 10 crore. Revenue in 2018, as we all know, like I have said earlier, 30,164 crore. India e-commerce market share by 2019 is 44%. Number of product available is 80 crore. Number of Flipkart sellers is 1 lakh. And number of product categories is 80. I want to add a number of shipments when they started in month they got only 8 per month shipments. Now they have number of shipments 80 lakhs.
Amazing, the data was amazing, and when I was searching this data yesterday I was just got shocked. So SWOT analysis, here I have discussed strength, weakness, opportunities and threats. So here in threat, it's a Reliance Retail. Anyone have heard about Reliance Retail, which is planning to come in the market? Anyone? So maybe this is a yes. So maybe this is a biggest threat for the Flipkart and the competition. We have very, very rough competition in e-commerce industry. We have Snapdeal, Flipkart is there, Amazon is there, ShopClues is there. So that is the biggest competition for Flipkart. And talking about opportunities, expansion of business, yes, definitely we have a chance of expansion because different types of companies, as I have said, different investors are ready to invest. So there is maybe a chances for the expansion in Flipkart. And talking about weakness, cost of acquisition, because we know when buyer saw some products on internet, he can switch within a second between two websites, Flipkart, and within a second to Amazon. So retention of customers is a biggest task for the Flipkart, not even Flipkart, for all the e-commerce industries. And talking about strength, own logistics distribution services, that's the amazing thing of the Flipkart. It is having their own logistics and distribution services. That's the biggest thing. And Flipkart backed by global investors. We know we have many investors for the Flipkart. So that's the great. Okay, next slide.
Yes, the challenges of Flipkart. Reduce sell. Unhappy sellers, no growth. When Walmart bought Flipkart, the CEO of Walmart said, buying a Flipkart is very easy, but running a Flipkart is very difficult.
Absolutely.
So, within 5 years, Flipkart has grown very. Flipkart grew very rapidly. They crossed 10,000 revenue. 10 crore revenue within a 5 year, but they could not maintain their momentum. That's why they face challenges: reduced sale, unhappy sellers, no growth, sleeping of market shares, opening and shutting the new pilot projects like flight, huge burden to maintain the logistic infrastructures.
So okay, finally we have 30 seconds left. Let's discuss about conclusion. So here, these are some stats. 83% of Flipkart tweets were retweeted by its followers. And 506K people are talking about Flipkart. 13 million visitors are visiting Flipkart daily. And in a second big billion sale, Flipkart saw a turnover of $300 million in gross merchandise volume. So that is amazing figures we have here to prove that Flipkart is the biggest brand. So here, thanks a lot and please support Flipkart.
Thank you, sir.